Yeah, I agree with President von der Leyen. So personally, I think originally we were confronted with something that nobody had ever been confronted with before. Let's not forget that. So we were learning very fast, and we're learning while we were doing, or I always say learning while we were racing. And so I think that worked initially relatively well. But then personally, I probably was too optimistic in terms of how people in general would continue to respect certain basic rules of social distancing and so masks. And that's where I think in the summer we probably should have done more, as they say in English, that you repair the roof when the sun shines, and that's when probably collectively we should have put more effort in testing and tracing. But the jury is still out. I would say that I agree. I mean, I think we need to look forward now. We need to also appreciate certain things like the enormous stress on people's livelihoods, on people's lives, the mental health issues and so on of these measures. And on the other hand, there is a need to combat this epidemic. And as I mentioned, if we don't get the epidemic under control, there's no way that the economy can revive. So that tension, how to manage that, is unprecedented. But the key now is that we, there's no time to waste, no time to lose, to put in place all these measures. The question is for how long can we go to a system where you have, let's say, what they call in Singapore, like circuit breaker for a few weeks' time, and then have a bit more relaxed and then go back. I mean, the biggest problem for both individuals, but also for companies, for institutions, for governments, is the difficulty in planning. Whether it's planning for, I don't know, your wedding, or planning for the budget for next year, etc. And so this is something we need to also think. So can we do that in a more way? And I don't have an answer to it, but at the moment, I think what this is a strong case for better coordination. That sounds very boring, but in this case, it's essential and can save lives at the European level to harmonize certain approaches and to quickly learn from each other, so that whenever we think that we have a better idea or something doesn't work next door, that we can take measures that are appropriate, and also looking beyond Europe. Both in terms of what not to do and what may work. And I'm convinced when you look at like East Asia and Southeast Asia, there's a very strong sense of community. And perhaps that's what we also need to come back to in Europe. I know this sounds like not very measurable, but at the end of the day, this is what it's going to take to defeat this virus. And also to accept the vaccine and to build a new society again. Over.